Remember the good old days of Attack on Titan Season 1 when there were two clear sides with two clear goals? Humanity, Titans, simpler times. Fast forward 3.5 seasons and you've got warriors, shifters, Eldians, Marlians, anti-Marlian volunteers, countless other nations, and now our newest Attack on Titan faction, the Yeagerists, otherwise known as the new Eldian Empire. So this will be a short video explaining who the Yeagerists are, what is their goal, why do they believe what they believe, and who their members include. So if you're loving Attack on Titan the final season like I am, but you think you could maybe benefit from an explainer, please enjoy, leave a like, and subscribe to get more AOT explainers like this one. And don't worry, this video will not cover manga spoilers whatsoever, we're only talking about what anime viewers should know as of season 4, episode 12. The Yeagerists are, in short, Eldians from Paradis Island, largely with military background training, who believe that Eren and Zeke Yeager are the future of Eldia, their only chance at survival, and the true leaders of the island. They believe that Eren Yeager was justified in his attack on Marley from season 4 episode 5, as the nation of Marley instigated violence after spending 100 years dropping Titans off on the island of Paradis. The Yeagerists are in support of Zeke's plan to activate a rumbling, which would involve the blood brothers Eren and Zeke making physical contact, causing Zeke's royal blood to unlock Eren's founding Titan power, allowing Eren to wake an unknown number of wall Titans to march onwards towards the rest of the world as a show of the new Eldian Empire's power. What we don't know as of the time of season 4 episode 12 is just how many of the wall Titans the Yeagerists want to wake, and how far do they want to take their show of force. Are they going to send just the Titans inside the area of wall surrounding Shiganshina, the Titans making up all of Wall Maria, or every Titan inside all three walls? And with the Titans they do unleash, are they going to have them trample over something like an empty city across the ocean, or all of Marley, or all of the world? Unfortunately, Eren isn't doing much talking this season, and Zeke is not currently in communication with a larger Yeagerist group as he's being detained by Levi, so we haven't heard either character explicitly answer those questions yet. But the main difference between the Yeagerists and the Eldian military, consisting of Hanji, Mikasa, Armin, etc., is that the Yeagerists want to act now. So we know that the Yeagerists want violence against the world they view as the aggressors, and they want it now. But who are they? Like, who are their members, and why do they align themselves with Eren and Zeke? Well, there's Yelena, who is a devout follower of Zeke and now of Eren too. Her original country was occupied by Marley years ago, and she was enlisted into the Marleyan army, serving in the front lines where she first encountered Zeke in his beast titan form. She believed that the titan power he showed was on the level of a god. She believes that together, Eren and Zeke have the power to reshape the world, and she'd rather be on their side when the world gets rewritten. Flock, in case you forgot, he was a new recruit around the time of the battle to retake Shiganshina in season 3 part 2. He was assigned to Erwin's team guarding the horses, and after Erwin's legendary final pep talk, he rode on his horse towards the Beast Titan, somehow being one of the very few people to survive that whole slaughter. Erwin's speech, in which he convinced a band of horrified recruits, you know, Flock included, to charge towards death for a greater cause, it made Flock believe in the power of a devil figure, someone who can make the difficult choices and say these really unspeakable things if it means victory. Erwin was Flock's devil in season 3, and Eren has become his devil figure in season 4. Flock really admires the attack Eren instigated in Liberia. Louise is a very young recruit who also, along with Flock, leaked information about Eren being detained to the public. We actually met Louise very briefly in season 1. She was saved by Mikasa as a little girl, and she feels an admiration and gratitude to the military for saving her. She basically spent the years between season 1 and 4 training to become a scout. Unfortunately, even though she idolizes Mikasa, she kind of believes in an idealistic fantasy version of Mikasa, the whole devote your heart thing, rather than the Mikasa standing in front of her. For that reason, she's devoted herself to protecting the citizens at all cost, and of course, following Eren at all cost. In a way, she's kind of like where Mikasa was in season 1. There's also the unknown members of the insurgents still hiding within the military. It was an anonymous group of scouts that caused the explosion that took out Zackly after all, and in the post-mortem meeting, our characters discuss the very real possibility that there are Yeagerists within the military, maybe even people in the room who could be undercover siding with Eren. We also have some of the Marleyan volunteers who Yelena worked very hard to find jobs for throughout society. We know there are genuinely good anti-Marleyan volunteers. Onyokapon swore to Hanji he didn't know what Yelena was doing, but that doesn't mean every volunteer was oblivious to Yelena's plan. I think the implication when Hanji mentioned the restaurant at the end of episode 12, it was to say that we don't just have to worry about Eren sympathizers being in the military, they could also be all throughout society, since Yelena saw to it that Marleyan would be able to find jobs on Paradis. And last but not least, speaking of society, there are citizens outside the capital who believe in the Yeager brothers others being their path to freedom and safety. Ultimately, these people want honesty and they want safety from their government. They feel like the military is keeping secrets from them and they are not taking actions to protect them, at least not fast enough. Meanwhile, they hear about how Eren Jaeger is planning to take care of all their problems by fighting against the outside world. It's kind of easy to understand why they would believe in Eren rather than the military. So that is everything we know about the Yeagerist movement. How was that? Do you have a better understanding now of who the new Eldian Empire is? Did I miss anything? If you have questions, comment down below. Please be cool and don't spoil anything for anime-only people if you know some manga spoilers. And if you liked the video, please hit like and consider subscribing. Oh, and let me know in the comments who you're currently siding with. Are you feeling the Yeagerist movement, or are you staunch in support of Hanji and the rest of the military? I am just blown away by everything Attack on Titan is doing this season, and I love talking about it. So until next time, take it easy.